Today's telecast is presented live from Brawltimore Scaryland in Red B&D Spank Stadium for today's game. The stadium is sold out and the atmosphere is electric. The fans want to see some hard-hitting carnage, and so do I.
I heard this city was famous for crabs. So if you get lucky tonight, Grim, make sure you take a shampoo with that Quell lotion and see a doctor.
Today's matchup promises severed limbs and ruined careers. The Leveland Burns take on the Baltimore Razors. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. The paddy wagons in the parking lots are full. The familiar scent of bodily fluids in the air. And the men's room is both flooding and on fire. And that means MFL Game Day is on the air. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzer along with Bricks and Bricks Jr.
Man, last week some mutant let out a lava blast in one of the stalls in the men's room. Place went up like an oil rig. Flames and explosions. Water shooting out of where the toilets were. I electrocuted myself using the electric hair dryer. I wish they had paper towels at least as an option.
Second down and long. Third down, and look out, that's an all-out attack on the cue.
It's not how many times you fall, it's how you get back up.
Yeah, in this particular case, I'm thinking defibrillators and 100 cc's of adrenaline. Rep and jumps off sides to kill him. First down and seven. And they run it for a couple of yards. Second down and five. He might have managed to dig out a yard on that one.
Not my yard. Got too much buried in, you know, the usual money, bodies, coffee cans filled with, well, you know, mostly coffee. Tastes better, like Eskimos burying salmon heads, kimchi. I'm adding anything really tastes good.
catches it for a touchdown. What a beautiful play.
Yeah, it's almost poetic, like a haiku.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It's good. When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
First and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
A good run for 5 yards.
Hey, didn't move the change of score, did it? How good can it be?
Second down and 5.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Nice hit. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Ouch! Anyone in the mood for a steak tartare? Second down and 2. He took a beast boost injection. Now watch him stomp all over his opponent.
I want to take a beast boost injection too.
Now that is weird side effects, Bricks. Oh, that's a vicious hit. And the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. Mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. Second down and 10. Oh, mama! He just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
Third and 4. Juice that player with to make him run that fast can't be legal.
I once saw a kicker make a kick like this with his extra leg. He used it like a golf club.
That wasn't a leg, you moron. That was trap.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just guineas.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's first and 10. And they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. Forever. He refuses to go down, and he runs it for 4 yards. Second down in a mile. He had it for a second there. It's anyone's game still at this point.
I know, which makes it so hard to place a bet.
Third down, and the offense needs a miracle. And he held on to that one for a first down. And it's first and ten.
Hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
That's a 4-yard gain. Second down and six. Well, little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. And it's first and ten. Well, that's a real buzzkill. He dropped it. If he does that again, they'll drop him. Second down and ten. And the ball is lateral to his teammate. We're talking. And that's some good old-fashioned downhill running as he picks up 9 yards on the play. That'll bring up third and one. I personally think that the ginormous guy is compensating.
First down! He hit that line the way a rolled up dollar bill sticking out of flimsy Lohan's nose hits a mare in Lost Wages, Nevada.
And it's first and ten. The way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and ten. And he picked up a lot of real estate in a hurry. Give him 10 yards right there. Second down and inches. They want more points, so they're going for two. And they run it in for 2 points. Team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! Oh, with a punishing hit! first and 10.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
He's not just burning down the house, he's taking it to the house. Nice run for 5 yards. Second down and 5. Target more often. And it's first and 10. There aren't too many players that kids can. Devastating hit knocks the ball loose. He could go all the way. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. The 20. The 10. Stop him. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. Completion. They're moving the ball now with authority. And he takes a timeout here. They have 2 left. I wonder if he has a plan.
Well, maybe he's just gonna take the teeth out of the back of his neck that have been stuck there since the opening play.
He's not going down. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy. QB saves some clock by calling a timeout. They have 1 left. And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
First down and 6. The quarterback burns his last time out. They can't stop the clock anymore. When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. Second down and a lot. Killer, it was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in the fantasy.
It's not short, but this one shouldn't give the kicker any trouble.
Unless he collapses under pressure and never makes another kick again.
That's bleak, Bricks. Straight through the uprights. Looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and 10. hits the field incomplete.
He threw it when no one could catch it. Some things like that in a quarterback.
It's a close battle as the quarter ends. Halftime is brought to you by those caring folks at Monsanto Industries. They make the world a better place by making the government tell you it is. Third quarter about to begin here, and these guys are locked in a nearly dead heat.
I was locked in a dead heat under the covers last night when Brick started farting like a 4th of July fireworks finale.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, Bricks. It means he can return it for... You know what? Never mind. On that play. Second down and 6. And this guy's running like an old guy looking for a bathroom. First down. And it's 1st and 10. Six. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey.
Actually, he does have some turkeys getting grafted on his backside from that bad burn he had last year.
And they line up for the extra point. Feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And it's 1st and 10. Tired of the quarterback's tight spirals and magnetic pursuit. If he was still talking, he'd probably be saying, Psycho killer, qu'est-ce que c'est? What the fuck, the fuck, the fuck?
I don't know what you are.
And it's 1st and 10. And he runs it in for the touchdown. And they come to the line trying to tie this up with 2 points.
And if they don't, things are going to get weird and desperate.
Bam! Gutsy run for the conversion.
No matter how many years in the league, I got to tell you, this don't get any less scary.
Ghost.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and 10. Oh, with the brain scrambler. And that'll be second down and 4. Down and 5. Oh, with a punishing hit. And it's first and 10. And that's how you run the football. A pickup of 7 on the play.
Friend, why is it that more mentally disturbed clowns don't play football? They'd be good.
You know, they're all in politics, apparently. First and 10. And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pick.
I'm not saying the rap has been rhymed, but he drove out of the field in a brand new hearse.
And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. First down and a mile. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. First down and forever. Hit. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. So he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Get the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
See that saw, Bricks? He never saw that.
I saw what you saw. A saw you never saw.
See, there's the saw there.
I see.
And they'll line up for the punt here. We're tied up at the end of the third quarter. You can smell the excitement on the fans. I mean, literally, it is ripe in here. Man.
Junior, was that you?
Hey, blow me.
Well, that's a lovely shank for the punter today. He just put his team in the hole.
And he just lets that one go. He says, no thank you, and the defense downs it. And it's first and 10. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep, third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
And Wildcats will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
And it's first and 10. Second down and more than the QB would like. Oh, and he just turned in. He just laid the wood on him on that one and knocked the ball out. And he's off to the races. He's at the 10. And he scores. You know, the league used to flag this for excessive celebration. You know, refs really don't want to get too close to the rabid, roided out monster. And don't even get me started on the werewolf. It should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It's good. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
First and 10. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. And that'll bring up second and 1. Run for no gain.
Then it's not really a run, is it?
And that'll bring up third and 1. And this guy just blew up and he's on fire. I'm not talking about one of those video game fire modes. I mean, literally, he's like burning bacon down there. And like bricks and balls, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. And it's first and 10. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. And into the end zone with a burst of speed.
I think he's more of a downest guy than a speed thing, Grim. He's running from his demons to clear.
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. The defense lost another linebacker on that play, and only two remain on their roster.
Their defense is getting very close to forfeiting this game. And it's first and 10. And that player just transformed into a giant. Oh, he fumbled that one. Everyone loves being on the highlight reel, leaping over a defender, but sometimes you get hit hard and have the ball knocked loose. And this werewolf is from London, I believe, signed in the offseason.
Yeah, I saw him at Trader Dick's hotel bar the other night. His hair was perfect.
Better watch out. He'll rip your lungs out, Bricks. Hey, Bricks, they're going for two here. And he fumbles it, Bricks. That was a screwed up play if I ever saw one. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
On that one, and he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Phil, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
And it's first and 10.
At least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
First and 4. And he rumbles into the end zone for the score.
I hope he's not gonna dance now.
Either way, they're going for two. And he gets into the end zone for the conversion. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. First and 10. Second down and a lot. 2 minutes left in the game. Hang on. Second down and long. Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be.
And they quickly call a timeout to stop the clock. Third down and the punter is warming up. Running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe two.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim.
The quarterback is controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just clock blocked the clock.
And the quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Grim, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense calls plays at the line of scrimmage and plays really fast. And he breaks away. The game on the line. It's fourth down and he makes the catch and they breathe. Killed him yet. He's wearing a new mink coat, for God's sake.
He's seven layers of smarmy, Grim. Oh, did we get out of here?
The defense is looking, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. The offense goes into their two-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry-up offense, you moron.
Oh, and the defense comes up with a huge stop on fourth down. Point, set, and match. Game over. You hear that, kid? Now put the controller down, put some pants on, and go get a goddamn job. I'm gonna say maybe 3 yards, but a tough 3 yards. And defense burns its last timeout. You can't take them into the locker room, so you might as well use them now.
Why would you want to take a timeout into the locker room, Grim? That doesn't sound right.
Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. And it's first and 10. Was there, but he still picked up a yard somehow. And that'll be second and 8 to go. Razors win the game in their own backyard. Now the neighbors can quit complaining and join the party. It was a hell of a battle, and they had just enough to cross the finish line.
Good thing they got juiced at halftime.
I want to get juiced now after listening to you two the entire game.
Listen up, guys. The MVP is about to speak. Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it.